Hi guys, this is Utkarsh here, and in today's presentation I would be talking about CFA level 1 classroom training program at Mumbai and Pune. So as some of you might know that we've been providing classroom and online CFA training programs for almost 7 to 8 years in Pune, and it's been a year we've started operating in Mumbai. So Pune, we are located near Pune University at an area called Bhosle Nagar, and in Mumbai we are located at Dadar West. So in my presentation would be roughly broken into four parts. The first part will have general discussion on what's our strategy, how the sessions are conducted, what are weekly tests. Then we will talk about what content would be provided to classroom participants. Then we will talk about how we will be helping you with placement activities and some of the other interesting stuff. And then towards the end, we'll have discussion on schedule, right? This is roughly a 4-point strategy. So I'm starting with the strategy piece first. Now in general, the sessions happen like this. Before your actual level one classroom sessions begin, we start with a program which is called level zero. Now it's a in-house program developed by us. And the whole idea with level zero is that a lot of people who come to us for training, a lot of times they are not from finance background, or at times they are from finance background, but they're studying after a lot of gap. So level zero is, you can think of it as some sort of a boot camp program, right? So we assume that people have no idea about finance, and we start with all the basics. So basics like how do you use financial calculator, or basics like what's derivatives, or what are equity markets, a little bit of linear algebra. So no matter what your background is, after level zero, you should be more or less, at a level playing field with the rest of the class. Once level zero is over, then your typical sessions will begin. Now the cycle works this way. Let's assume you attend session one, maybe on Sunday or Saturday, depending on which location you're attending at. So let's assume you attend your first session on Sunday morning. Now, once first session is done, then you're given a target that in about 7 days from that day, which means on next Sunday, there would be a weekly test. Okay. And in between those 7 days, based on the session that we have conducted, you have time for self-study. And we also typically do something called as a midweek session, right? So this would be like a capsule session. It would be conducted live online, not physical. The actual sessions are live physical, but midweek session is like a small capsule of maybe 2 hours. This is where we kind of revise what we did on previous Sunday. And then with the help of your self-preparation and midweek session, you go and write the weekly test. And then in this fashion, your cycle keeps on repeating till your exams, right? This is roughly the play in terms of how the sessions are conducted. So as I discussed, there would be level zero sessions at the beginning. Then there would be regular weekly sessions. This could either be on Sundays, Saturdays, or they could be on weekdays. And we'll have a little bit of more discussion about that on the schedule part. Then we will have those capsule midweek online live sessions. Then of course we'll have a weekly test. Now, what is this tunnel vision? So typically, I've seen candidates stress a lot about how are we going to finish such a large curriculum within 4 months or 5 months, and what do I study now? Should I be studying new concepts or should I revise? So what we do in this system is we recommend you not to worry about your own planning. And I know I'm kind of making a drastic comment, but we recommend you that you outsource your entire planning part to us. And what we would be doing is we would be giving you a weekly target in terms of your weekly test. So you need to have a tunnel vision, just prepare for your weekly test and then move on to next week. And then we will ensure that the weekly tests are structured in such a way that at any point of time you're well revised with the topics which have been done in the past, and you're comfortable with the topics which are happening in the class right now. Okay, so that's how weekly tests work. Now, typically your curriculum gets over roughly about 30 days before the exams. And then in the final month, we spend a lot of time on mock exams, and we generally have a intensive revision course, right? This is roughly how the whole play is going to be. Now, one important thing is that the objective when you're taking this course, of course, A, to pass the exams, but more important, to learn finance, right? That's maybe the reason why all of us are into this program. So during classroom sessions, we will make sure that we are doing a lot of real world examples. For example, what Vodafone will do in the market is a function of how, what is the strategy of Airtel vis-a-vis what is the strategy of Idea Cellular vis-a-vis what is the strategy of course, Reliance Jio. So, and therefore they have built a lot of mathematical models on oligopoly. One of the very famous model is Nash Equilibrium. I'm sure some of you might have seen the movie. Have you? So there's this movie called...
We would also talk about Asian currency crisis and who had major plays in those crises and stuff like that. Your sessions would be colorful. We would not be kind of using a traditional notebook, textbook type of approach. I would be asking you to bring your post-its and maybe highlighters, sketch pens, and there would be a lot of drawings happening throughout the season. There are a lot of innovations and techniques that we keep on using in the classroom. At times we'll be playing games, or at times you know, there would be quizzes and stuff like that. We have this interesting concept called warm-up session and jamming session. So you'd get to experience that. And of course, most importantly, it's important that we have fun throughout the process, right? So this is roughly how your classroom strategy is going to be. Then in terms of content, you would be getting access to juice notes. You can look at a sample of juice notes on the screen. These are colorful flowchart where we have kind of condensed the entire curriculum in about 300 pages. Security. And they are quite comprehensive. So your classroom notes that you would be taking along with me in the class and the juice notes, this would be a reasonable framework for you to prepare. Then you'd be getting access to FinTree's video lectures. Now, that's roughly a total content of 150 hours. And that content is broken down into three parts. So we have main videos, which are again learning broken down into LOS fashion. These are about 120 hours. Then we have Q&A videos where we have solved about 30 to 40 questions on every reading. These are roughly 30 to 40 hours, and that's how it becomes at 150. And then additional videos, which I haven't counted in that 150. So additional videos are like support videos, you know, so most of the curriculum, you'd be comfortable just by doing this. But let's say you feel you're not good with quant, you know, and you need more help. That's where you go to additional videos. And additional videos by themselves, you know, would be roughly about 100 odd hours. So that's the kind of content, video content you'd be getting. There is no limit on how many times you can watch them. Of course, there's a limit on the validity, but there's no limit on how many times you can watch them. And all these videos are recorded in the live classroom, so you can watch them as many times as you want. Then you'd be getting our popular commuter notes. These are MP3 files. You can download them on your mobile phone, and they are conversation style. They are not, you know, one guy preaching stuff. They are guys where I and some of my students, we sat and we discussed stuff. So they're very useful when you cannot study actively, you know, maybe when you're driving or maybe when you're cooking, that's where you can make use of your commuter notes. Then of course you'll be getting weekly test. Almost every weekly test is about 120 questions, and roughly in a season we end up doing 17 to 18 weekly tests. So you're looking at total content, total number of questions, to the range of about 2000 questions. And then in the final month, we would have a series of mock exams where we would try to simulate, you know, what's happening, how your day is going to be on the day of final exams, right? So this is the content that you get. I think the whole ecosystem is extremely comprehensive. So you would not be needing to purchase any additional material apart from what we would be providing. So of course, all of you would need access to CFA curriculum, and I would tell you how to make use of that material and the material that FinTree provides, and that's going to do the job for you. Then our popular placement program. So the way it worked is about you know, until 2015, a lot of the students used to come to me and they used to say that, you know, Utkarsh, I need help with placements. So do you know anyone in XYZ company? And then I used to dig our alumni database and find out people, make them calls and share the details. And then in 2015, we thought, you know, why not institutionalize the whole process? So we kind of build a team. That team is made purely, so we kind of try to operate like a B school. So we have a placement team every season, which is made of the classroom participants as well. And then the entire placement works on alumni network. And then every FinTree classroom participant gets a lifetime access to our placement services. Yes, you heard that right. It's lifetime. And the idea is very simple. The idea is that we will help you with your placements when you need it. And then we will expect you to help us back, you know, helping other candidates. So it's a purely alumni driven network. Fortunately for us, that placement has worked really well. In fact, a lot of companies in the region approach us because they know at any point of time we have reasonable, good quality candidates to be placed. So each one of you would get a lifetime access to placements. Again, like, we don't promise, we don't say that we will get you a job. You know, that's not our core expertise. Our expertise is to help you pass CFA exams. But I'm quite sure you'd benefit with our placement program. Then all of you would also have a lifetime access to the FinTree Connect sessions. So the idea with Connect sessions is, you know, let's say you learned about hedge funds in alternative investments. But then you would also want to know, you know, what's happening in the market right now. And this is where we invite a lot of people from industry. They would come and talk to you about, you know, what's happening in the industry today, what is their day-to-day job, how do you break into the industry and stuff like that. So in the past, we've had some very popular Connect sessions. The recent one we had, I think the last one was titled How to Get into Wharton Business School. Okay, that was the last Connect session. Prior to that, we had a session on how to break into investment banking. Prior to that, we had a session on blockchain. So stuff like this keeps on happening. And again, each one of you would be getting a lifetime access to placement and Connect sessions. Right, so this was about placements. And finally, about the schedule, Mumbai and Pune. So in Mumbai, the weekly sessions are conducted as of now. This is May 2018. So as of now, the Mumbai sessions are conducted on every Saturday morning in the first half. So the timing is 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. Okay, so this is the one format that's available in the Mumbai. In Pune, you have two options. So your option one, that we have sessions on every Sunday. This is like our flagship program, which is extremely popular, which is 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Sunday morning. And then another option is we have a weekday program. The weekday program is conducted 3 days in a week, live sessions again, which is Wednesday, Thursday. I'm so sorry, I made a mistake here. Which is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, morning 7:40 to 11 a.m. Okay, so 7:40 to 11 a.m. is the weekday format. Apart from this, you'll have to spend additional 3 hours with us every week on your weekly test. So no matter which format you decide to join, writing weekly test for every classroom participant is compulsory. You know, in fact, we do take weekly tests very seriously. So your results will come out in a notice board, and there would be a lot of competition in the class because you know, it kind of pushes us hard. So you see other guys doing well, you see your scores below, you get an opportunity to benchmark and you keep on improving on the whole process. So this is roughly the schedule. Apart from this, I would be using a lot of public holidays, right? And that's the kind of a notice that I give to all the classroom participants in advance. And I understand that many of you would be working, and you know, many of you might not have Indian public holidays off, many of you might not have US, but I still end up using them. However, we would be publishing the schedule almost 5 months in advance. So you would have a day-wise breakup, time-wise breakup. So in case if there is a session scheduled on a public holiday, but it's not an off for you, you can always apply for a leave, right? That's roughly how it works. Now, we don't use too many public holidays, but on an average, you can expect at least 3 to 4 sessions being conducted on public holidays in a season. So that's roughly the schedule. And more or less, I think I've covered the agenda. In case if you have any further questions, you have any doubts, the best way to reach out is you can call up our admin team on 888-0777722, or you can email us on admin@fintreeindia.com. So thank you very much, and I'll see you again in the next video.